not going to ask you to introduce yourself because everybody already knows who you are. What role does education play in the ladies?
Well, to be quite honest, it was really a gateway for me.
We're waiting for Theodora.
I know that's not the case with everybody, but as this last summer, they actually left school early to go to the NFL, and they finished my degree this last summer.
Yeah, I heard that.
So what did you get your degree?
I got my degree in history.
I have no idea.
Okay. So let's say you come back and bring your didn't have this.
That's
what you are. But the athletic ability that you have. What do you think you would do?
Well, I would be teaching, which I'm still interested in doing. But to be honest, football is something that really came natural to me. It's way more of a success story for someone to be a lawyer or a doctor. Because it's something that's not natural to us. And I don't mean that in a negative way. What I mean is when Eastern Europeans come to America, they come from a society that's based on education, you know, from the Greeks to the Italians, you know, they've come from centuries and centuries of higher education. Where we come from, self-sustaining, you know, we're able to self-sustain even as of 20 years ago, even now today, you know, many people suffer. And to me, that's way and above higher education. But when we start going into education, you know, our mind has to think differently. That's why I think that going into football is that natural, because we're tribal people, we're warriors, we're farmers, we're self-sufficient, whereas people that come from Europe really aren't. So football is something that's very, very close to our type of culture. That's why I think it's really more of a success story to see doctors come from somewhere and lawyers come from somewhere.
One of the things I try to teach is the college. I'm also the lawyer for the college. And I try to tell the students that, and people coming out, not everybody's going to be Troy Polamalu and the other NFL players. It's one out of thousands.
The syndrome is not just for Samoa, the syndrome is for everyone, because they don't seek money, really. People seek prestige, they seek fame, they seek celebrity, which isn't a real authentic way of life. What we all have, which we actually have here in Samoa, because originally being style efficient, is happiness. And you don't need money for that. All you need is enough food on the table. And that's what we have here, you know. We have people that can get up, that can raise pigs, raise chickens, that can eat their eggs, that can grab honey off a tree, that can eat coconuts, drink coconut water. We're farmers, we're fishermen. In reality, you don't need anything else.
If you were able to talk to which you are, about graduating from high school or younger ages, what would you advise them before graduating from high school?
Before graduating from high school, it would be just to take everything in and enjoy your time. It's you know, the greatest time of my life. You know, graduating or before graduating from high school, my whole high school experience. Second of all, would be is further your education. It's true. There's more football players out there than there are doctors and lawyers. And that's the real success story. Not to take anything away from anybody that's really pursuing professional football, but the real success story for me personally, and I'm more happy and proud of, is when I see someone, a lawyer or a doctor.
So, with this, somebody was telling me about educating yourself on video as far as becoming a success. You have to be able to be an educated player.
Well, you know, there's different kinds of players. There's players that really think that are real statistical thinkers and real calculated thinkers. There's guys that just play on pure instinct. There's guys, neither really. But there's guys that are that can do both. I think the best are guys that can do both, because you're not limited by anything. are too in one way, it's easy to break those guys down. If you're a really instinctual guy, it's really to break those guys down. But if you're a little bit of both, we, as Samoans, have everything instinctual, which is great. But what we're here to do is up our football IQ and be able to be really calculated thinkers and technicians. And in that way, I think, you know, have a better quality football player than leaves the island.
Anything else you'd like to mention about education to people out there?
Education for us Samoans to be able to come back. I'm able to come back and share football, but that's my experience. To be able to go to Harvard, go to an Ivy League school, and bring that education back to Samoa, go above and beyond infinite exponential times of what I could ever do. If we have someone step up to do that, that's the person that we need for the future.
Well, thank you for whatever other thing you're doing for us. I wish you could get the college. You're up on Friday. I'll probably be around there. Can I have your signature for the college on this? You got all your shirts, right?
Oh, yeah. Somebody grabbed them out of there.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah. But what about the...
We're almost warm today.
Okay. I have a girly shirt. I don't know. Anything else?
Good.
Well, let me give you this.
Thank you for your patience.
No. Thank you.
No, you didn't have to do this.
I really appreciate it. Being able to roll out, I told him like these sales just graduated. So we got a great spot of that.
Sorry to hear that.
I'm sorry.